Hello friends, I'm Dr. Pooja Kapoor, Consultant Pediatric Neurologist, Director and Co-Founder Continua Kids. So today, we'll just talk about three simple steps as how to potty train a child who has got autism spectrum disorder. So as we all know that it's very difficult to potty train a child, and there are various reasons to that. First could be maybe they don't have the urge, they don't feel the urge of key when they have to go to the washroom to evacuate the bladder. Second, even they may have be having the urge, but they don't know how to communicate it to the parents or the caregiver. The third could be they may be having so many sensory phenomena somewhere, like they don't, maybe they may not be liking the sound of the water flowing in the washroom, or maybe the rim, they don't like to sit on the potty seat. Third could be they're just claustrophobic in that small washroom. They are fearful going there. So whatsoever may be the cause, we are going to discuss on three simple steps as how to potty train. The first is, like, you should also be aware of that you should not potty train a child in extreme of winters, especially if you are living in North India, because we get like very harsh winters, and maybe they may not like the cold water. When you are cleaning them, on the rim is of the pot is very cold, so they may not appreciate or like the rim or like sitting there. So make sure that the season is appropriate, the temperature is good. Now, the first step is that you have to create a pressure so that in the morning he has adequate amount of pressure build up. So as you let him sit on the pot, he has to pass that. So to do that, what we do is at night we tell the caregivers that we give adequate amount of laxative. Laxative is like any substance which causes increase in the motility of the gut. Something, for example, like syrup loose or Dufalac or something. So what it does is that it increases the motility of the intestine. So by the morning you make him sit on the pot, he has very high pressure which is built up. And it's very difficult to just stop that. So the amount of laxative is depending on different child that can have different amount. Some may settle down with 5 mL, some may require 10 or 15 or 20. That you have to talk to your pediatrician or your concerned person. Second step is you have to make him sit. The first thing you have to do is always in the morning, just make him get him up and take him and make him sit on the pot. It has to be continuous for next 30 days without even a single break. So it will just sit in his brain that every morning the first thing he has to do is go and sit on the pot. So every morning, just as soon as he gets up, take him and make him sit on the pot. The third step is you have to make him sit on the pot for at least 10 to 15 minutes so that he passes the pressure which has been created by the laxative last night. And to do that, make sure whatever is possible, if he wants to have some screen time, I'll just let him go do that. If you like singing, if you want to sing there, if you want to talk, if you want to just make him sit on the pot for next 15 minutes. And no matter what he wants, if he likes to eat some candy in the washroom, it's okay. You want to have a movie or a play or whatever, just make him sit. So once this habit gets in for next 30 days, this will be automatically fixed into his mind that every morning you have to go there and sit. And then you can stop the laxative, make sure the food which you are giving does not cause constipation. Because a lot of children who have autism spectrum disorder have a lot of gastrointestinal phenomena in the form of constipations and diarrheas and all. So make sure that you just get rid of that before you start doing the potty training. And suppose my child has got a lot of constipation, make sure the food which you are giving has a lot of fiber, so that even if after you remove the laxative, he has got good amount of pressure there in the morning. So as we do this, I've just tried this with a lot of my children and they have all been successful. So make sure you follow these three steps for 30 days. And I think more than 90% of my children would be doing well, and you won't require anything after that. So I think this will make some sense to you all. Try this with your children, and best of luck for QWERTY training. Thank you so much.